In the perioral area, it's important to use very gentle fluid products, which have a good duration and, very importantly, can be completely reabsorbed. So, I'm going to use Aliaxine FL, ideal in this case since it has precisely the necessary properties. It's a product based on hyaluronic acid, and so is totally reabsorbable, extremely fluid and easy to use, and moreover long-lasting. I'm going to treat this patient's perioral area. Afterwards, I'll be redefining the contour of the lips, and I'll then carry out a type of perilift treatment of the upper and bottom lips. And finally, I'll give some support to the area where we find the marionette lines. I'm going to use Aliaxine FL, a product which combines good duration, due to the stability of cross-linked hyaluronic acid, with excellent fluidity, making it the ideal product for the perioral area. Here I'm going to create volume and enhance the definition of the upper lip, which is much finer than the bottom one, where by contrast I'll just give slight definition to the contour of the lip. I'll have to slightly increase the volume of the upper lip to make it more symmetrical to the bottom one. Injecting the product must always be carried out very slowly, particularly in the extraction phase. In this case, the injection is made very deep in order to add volume to the lip. As I said, the product should always be injected very, very slowly to reduce any patient discomfort. After the first deep level treatment, I'll carry out a second, more superficial injection to raise the lip border. The second application is therefore more superficial to create definition. In this case, the treatment has been carried out at two depths. The first at a deep level for volume enhancement, and the second to recreate definition to the contour of the lips. The second stage is much more superficial than the first, because it has the effect of working on the border of the lip, and therefore of increasing the definition of this area. In this case, we've carried out a first deeper level treatment to work on the volume of the lip and a second more superficial stage for definition. I'm now going to treat the central part, Cupid's bow. Now I'll redefine the contour of the lower lip slightly, staying close to the surface, since rather than creating any greater volume, I want to give slightly better definition to the contour of the lip. Now, with a very superficial injection, I'll be correcting the marionette lines. I'll treat the marionette line with an initial horizontal injection to lift the corner of the mouth, staying very near the surface. treating the marionette lines again, starting with a horizontal injection to support the corner of the mouth, and then close to the surface using the fanning technique.